Today I'm going to show you guys how to turn any vector into a brush or a texture brush using Adobe Illustrator. So learn how to turn a vector into a brush for your graphic designs in today's Satori Graphics graphic design tutorial. What is up people, welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. So today a very quick but very cool tutorial on how to turn any vector into a brush or texture brush in Adobe Illustrator. We're actually looking at three different brushes, so let's jump into today's graphic design tutorial. Here I have 61 brush vectors that I made myself. You can download them over on my website via the link in the description below for a small fee. They're going to come in handy for various graphic design projects I'm sure, and I'm going to show you how to turn these vectors into texture brushes, as well as how to use them. This works for any vector however, but if you want to download these brushes, click the link in the description and grab yourself 61 brush vectors that are on sale right now. The first thing we need to do is to open up the brush window here, or you can press F5 on your keyboard. You need to select the vector you want to turn into a brush first of all, so let's choose one from the selection. Once you've done that, click the top right corner in the brush window and select a new brush. In this tutorial today, we're going to be looking at three Illustrator brushes, the scatter brush, the art brush, and the pattern brush. So let's start with the art brush. If you use scale proportionally, it's simply going to draw the vector as it is. However, we want to use a cool texture brush effect, so we're going to use stretch. Always use tints and shadows, because that's going to allow you to use color on your vectors. As you can see, our brush has been added to the brushes window. Now simply locate the brush tool here and draw a line like so. This is a really cool effect, and experiment with different vectors for brushes will have interesting outcomes. We can also make a circle like so with a stroke only. And then once you have the circle selected, simply press the brush in the brush window and Illustrator is going to stretch the brush around the circle. That's a pretty cool effect. Remember to outline the stroke if you want to edit the shape itself once you're happy with the stroke weight. For the next brush, we're going to use a different vector, and once you have it selected, use a scatter brush. This is pretty straightforward. Keeping the settings as default works fine, but of course use tints and shadows as we did before. Locate the brush tool with B or in the toolbar, and then draw on your canvas like so. Let's make a square instead of a circle this time. I've just added the brush before, which looks pretty cool, but let's add the scatter brush. So as you can see, this tries to position the vector around the square like so. And the last brush we're looking at today is the pattern brush. So again, select a vector, and then create a new pattern brush in the brush window. We now have options that allow us to evenly or unevenly spread the pattern around a line. This is going to depend on your design and the vector that you're using. We can draw with this brush, or we can even make a pen tool path or a shape and add the pattern around it. This is great for borders and designs, as you can add any single vector you want to a pattern along a path. You can then of course use a direct selection tool to manipulate the path in various different ways. So there is my tutorial on how to turn any vector into a brush using Adobe Illustrator. Let me know what you guys thought of today's video in the comment section below. Remember to like and subscribe to my channel if you do find my content useful, and also share my videos on social media. I hope you guys did find this tutorial insightful, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.